globally renowned management thinker, an eminent thought leader, a prolific writer, with several international bestsellers to his credit. Professor Coimbatore Krishnarao Prahlad, known to close friends as CK, was all this and more. He was deeply committed to India's economic, cultural and moral development, a commitment that led to the Padma Bhushan being conferred on him in 2009. Professor CK Prahlad was a distinguished university professor at the University of Michigan and was twice voted the world's leading management thinker by Thinkers 50, first in 2007 and again in 2009. He was also the winner of four McKinsey Awards for the best article of the year in the Harvard Business Review. He is best known for his pioneering work titled The Fortune at the Bottom of the Pyramid, a book in which he outlined a model for large firms to engage with the economically backward sections of society. The Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Manmohan Singh, in his message said, Professor Prahlad's brilliance was dazzling. He was widely acclaimed as one of the most influential management thinkers ever, and his contribution to modern business theory and practice was invaluable. Professor Prahlad's bold and amazingly innovative ideas benefited companies around the world, including those of India. He was also a prolific writer, well known for many seminal works in the field of management.
Leaders must lead. You cannot lead unless you are future-oriented. Leadership is about the future. Leadership is about a point of view about that future.
Strategy to me is about folding the future in. It is not extrapolating the past and certainly not positioning yourself in the current. We need to have clarity to the goals and the belief that we can invent the means.
We must have a point of view of India we want to create and how to convert the principles enshrined in the Constitution into reality. I would like to call this Sampurna Azadi.
The drive to entrepreneurship, the fundamental premise is your aspiration must always exceed your resources. You must have an aspiration which by design, not by default, which by design must exceed your resources. And that is when you create creativity and you get innovation. Benchmarking by definition assumes somebody is already there.
India needs next practices. India must have the courage to chart its own path.
And in the last 5 years, I've been spending a lot of time looking at opportunities at the bottom of the pyramid. We have the most phenomenal opportunity in the world.
I suggested in a paper I wrote called My Vision for India at 75 that the first step is to educate 500 million Indians in world-class skills. We must realize that achieving social justice in a complex polity such as India requires socio-political innovations of a massive scale. We have to reimagine politics and governance as it is practiced in India.
500 Rajas lived in this country before independence. The British did not want independence. In spite of all that, without television, without internet, without radio, without large number of newspapers, we created a common vision for all of India. I believe that India has the opportunity to actively shape the emerging world order. I believe that this is something that happens once in 50, 60 years. Once in a lifetime opportunity for India.
India has the potential to be the beacon of hope for the whole world. Sense of Indianness is a prerequisite to accomplish this goal. India is the largest single experiment in democracy and social justice the world has ever seen. Leaders in India, in fact all Indians, have to ask themselves, what will be the judgment of history? What will be our legacy? I also believe that people want to be heard more than anything else. They hunger for opportunity more than handouts.